Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. In this video, we're going to see the effect of how long it takes these air check test kits to get to the lab. These are prepaid envelopes, so you could throw this in the mail, but there's a better chance that it doesn't get to the lab on time and it might not get analyzed, and then it's going to take longer, so it might not be as accurate as if you had overnighted it to the lab. And what we've got set up here is a whole bunch of duplicate tests where all of our devices are about 4 inches apart from each other. Now, I'm going to run this test for 4 days, and then I'm going to write down what all of my radon monitors are reading after that 4 day test. And I'm going to take two of these air check test kits and drop them in the mail. And the other two, I'm going to UPS overnight to the lab. And we'll see how the results of the ones that are overnighted and the ones that are snail mailed to the lab stack up against everything. So one thing to keep in mind before sending your air check test kits back to the lab is that you want to make sure you send it to the correct address. So this is a PO box, and that's fine if you're using the United States Postal Service. However, if you are using FedEx or UPS to send them back to the lab, they will not send to PO box. So you're going to have to keep the instructions handy, as they have the FedEx and UPS address that you will need. All right, we finally got our results back from the lab, and they were a little bit interesting. And before I let you know what those results are, I've got one correction to make. So I brought the air check test kits to UPS to overnight them to the lab, and overnight shipping on 4 test kits was like $90 some. So 2 day shipping was $34. So I opted for that method. And then in reviewing air check's instructions, they don't say anything about overnight shipping. They do recommend using FedEx or UPS. So I did 2 day shipping. We got results in 2 days, and the two that we used for UPS came back at 0.3 and 0.5, plus or minus 0.3 picocuries. Now, the ones I dropped in the mailbox and we used the Postal Service for, those, interestingly enough, had a different arrival date, very different arrival date. One of them took 3 days to arrive. The result on that one was 0.7 picocuries, plus or minus 0.3 picocuries. And the other one took 9 days to arrive. I was beginning to wonder, like, is it going to arrive? Did it get lost in the mail? That one had a result of 0.3 picocuries, but plus or minus 1 picocurie. So a much bigger margin of error there. They did all come back within acceptable ranges. And compared to everything else, they are kind of right in there. You know, our professional radon tests were 0.6, and then our consumer grade monitors, you know, were in that 0.8 to 0.9 range. So we kind of got everything in between there. So nothing really stood out as, you know, unacceptable or a major cause for concern. And then one thing in looking at air check's instructions that I noticed online too, is that they say time does matter. So a test kit that is analyzed within 3 to 4 days of its end date is going to be more accurate than one that, you know, takes more than a week to arrive. If it does take 8 days or more, it's just an estimated level of what the radon is. And then anything that takes more than 11 days is not going to be analyzed. So moral of the story is, you can throw it in the mailbox, but it is going to be, there's going to be a larger amount of uncertainty. So I hope you found the video helpful. If you did, give it a like, consider subscribing. And until next time, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. Thank you so much for watching.